So I would love to talk about Stir It Up, which is the first song on the second part of that Catch a Fire album. And it's worth talking a little bit about Stir It Up because I think in Stir It Up, we begin to see some of the genius of Bob Marley. The genius of Bob Marley to do a number of things. The first thing is, of course, his capacity for the metaphor and for the double entendre, which is the sort of more sexual thing. So there's that idea of how he employs the metaphor to articulate feelings and experience and so on. But the second thing that we see demonstrated in Stir It Up is the way in which he is using the language of his landscape, the language and the idioms of his landscape, his world, to express a romantic idea, in this case, a more se sexually charged idea, but it's to express love. He's not borrowing from anywhere else, but he's drawing out of his own specific landscape, not just the landscape, but the third thing is using the language of his world, his society, and creating an idiom and a capacity for that idiom to be a way to articulate the experience of people in Jamaica without feeling as if entering that idiom, one entering that space of writing about romance and writing about love, one would have to borrow it from the Hollywood movies. One would have to borrow it from the R&B songs. One would have to borrow it from the Frank Sinatra canon and so on. But actually finding that inside the Jamaican experience, and these things are hugely important. So if you imagine that one of the colonial experiences, one of the problems with colonialism was the way in which it denied a society of its own language, its own understanding of itself, and its own way to perceive itself in a certain kind of way. And very often, both colonialism and imperialism, the influence of other cultures, created a situation in which there was a perception that using the language of that society, and in the case of Jamaica, using the language of the poor, using the language of the Jamaican dialect, was not sufficient, was not up to the high ideas, to high thoughts, to romantic thoughts and ideas. What Marley radically shifts is that using that same idiom and that language, you can not only speak about high spiritual matters, but you can also speak about complex political matters. You could create sublime poetry, and of course, you could speak of romantic expressions of desire and feeling using that language. We'll see that sort of in the most heightened way in a song like No Woman No Cry, which will come much later on when we are discussing that. But here in Stir It Up, we see a great example of how Marley begins to employ language in very, very important ways and transformative ways. You know the song. If you haven't heard the song, you probably have heard it on the elevator or somewhere. If you've been to anywhere in Florida for a holiday or something like that, you'll hear the song. Because, of course, the song has been sort of repeated and replayed. The lyric is very interesting, very straightforward. Stir it up, little darling, stir it up. It's been a long, long time since I've got you on my mind. And now you are here, it's so clear. See what we can do, baby, just me and you, we could stir it up. So it's very straightforward. That's the simplest thing. It's been a long time since I've had you on my mind. And now you are here, it's so clear. That quick double rhyme. See what we can do, baby or honey. It's just me and you. We could stir it up. And of course, the implication is that we can stir up something. And it's beginning to build that metaphoric language, right? And then, of course, the next verses, I'll push the wood. I'll blaze your fire, then I'll satisfy your heart's desire. Said I'll stir it, yes, every minute, and all you've got to do, honey, is keep heating it. Now, right away, he's gone into a conceit, into a metaphor, right? I'll push the wood and blaze your fire. You can see this, and you can see already that instead of thinking about cooking, because cooking is the conceit, cooking is the metaphor. He's talking about love as cooking. But where does this cooking take place? This cooking doesn't take place with a gas range or with an electric range in a stove top somewhere. But Marley speaks about his world. In the world of Kingston, Jamaica, in that ghetto community, people didn't cook inside, they cooked outdoors. They cooked on coal fires that they lit up on and would put pans on the pot outside. And the way to keep the heat going, as many of you would know, if you've done camping, you've been camping, is to push the wood under the fire to blaze the fire. So he says, I'll push the wood and blaze the fire, and then I'll satisfy your heart's desire. Said, I'll stir it every minute, which you have to do to keep, you know, to keep the stew cooking and not sticking. I'll stir it every minute, and all you've got to do is keep the heat going, he says. And that's the lyric. But of course, what we don't know, unless you know the Jamaican idiom and the Jamaican dialect, is the word wood is also used in reference to the male penis. That is, so the idea is, so in Jamaican slang, there's that double meaning. The wood is a penis, a distended penis. And so when he says, I'll push the wood and blaze your fire, it's sexual. And the Jamaican listener would get it, even though they are understanding it to be this wonderful metaphor at the same time. And then, of course, I'll push the wood and blaze your fire, and I got to satisfy your heart's desire. I'll stir it every minute, and all you've got to do is keep heating it. Then, of course, the final verse is, quench me when I'm thirsty. Won't you cool me down when I'm hot? Your recipe, darling, is so tasty, and you sure can stir your pot. So we could stir it up, little darling, stir it up. Stir it up, little darling, stir it up. And in that moment, we can see what Marley has managed to do, that he's expressing this wonderfully sexual, playfully sexual, because, of course, it's double entendre. It's a double talk. He is expressing the joy of this affection and so on and so forth, and sensuality. But he's also doing it in a language that belongs to his society and so on, a language that is denigrated by even people in that society. And he's elevating it to make it a language that allows him to speak about, in that sort of marvelesque way, Andrew Marvel way, had we but world enough and time, this coyness lady wear no crime. That language of desire and seduction, and he does it with the wit of this double entendre. So Stir It Up is this wonderful. Song. And I, before we end this, I think it might be good to just play a little bit of it. It starts with that wonderful soft feel behind it. Just the guitar is going. There's the bass. There's a wonderful version of this on YouTube, and it's called a whistle stop version, the BBC whistle stop. And it's them performing live in London. It's beautifully done. And you should look it up. Stir it up. says, I push the wood, blaze your fire. Then I'll satisfy your heart's desire. Said I'll stir it every minute. All you've got to do, baby, is keep it till the end. It's great. One of the best parts of this song, of course, is the incredible solo instrumental section that bridges it. It's just incredibly beautiful. And it's this wonderful dance between the organ and the guitar. And it's just a beautifully done thing. Very sensual, nice feel, nice rhythm, and so on. So that's Stir It Up. And so we'll stop with Stir It Up.